To review from the previous video, nuclear security is the prevention and detection of and response to theft, sabotage, unauthorized access, illegal transfer, or other malicious acts involving nuclear or other radioactive substances, or their associated facilities. Nuclear security is often characterized by the phrase guards, guns, and gates. But in reality, you cannot just throw these things at a nuclear facility, even if it was to the maximum extent possible, and expect the facility to remain secure. Nuclear security involves the coordination of those guards, guns, and gates with identification of and intel about possible adversaries, legislative and regulatory frameworks, detection and monitoring systems. Also, culture and even the threat that comes from within a facility itself. This section will delve into these various aspects of nuclear security. The concept of nuclear security first appeared in policy in 1965. Then, 1970s terrorist attacks on U.S. personnel and interests abroad during the Nixon administration strengthened regulations with the possibility that terrorists might turn their attention to nuclear. September 11, 2001 was a major turning point in nuclear security. It showed that terrorists are no longer just trying to target small populations and carry out small attacks, but carry out grander attacks on indiscriminate populations. Since Al-Qaeda and its affiliates stated their desire to go nuclear, and ISIS's willingness to use chemical weapons illustrates their potential willingness to acquire nuclear or radioactive materials or to sabotage a nuclear facility for the purpose of releasing radiation. In the 2016 Nuclear Security Summit, President Obama stated that the risk of ISIS or other extremists getting nuclear weapons remains one of the greatest threats to global security. Although this threat does not only exist from terrorist organizations, because the threat does exist, the goal of nuclear security is to keep the risk of a nuclear incident as low as possible. Each state is ultimately responsible for providing their own nuclear security. Because nuclear security is a global concern, the IAEA helps by creating guidance. This guidance is in the Nuclear Security Series. This series began in 2006 and currently consists of 25 publications. The series is divided up into four categories: Nuclear Security Fundamentals, Nuclear Security Recommendations, Implementing Guides, and Technical Guidance. The key document of the Nuclear Security Series is under Fundamentals. It's the only document under Fundamentals, in fact. It's called Nuclear Security Series 20, Objectives and Essential Elements of a State's Nuclear Security Regime. Although Nuclear Security Series 20 describes 12 essential elements for nuclear security, there is one essential element described, the legislative and regulatory framework, that will help create a baseline for implementing a nuclear security system for each facility. The legislative and regulatory framework should cover all nuclear security within the state and should begin with the legislative domain of a state considering facilities containing nuclear materials. From this legislative framework, administrative systems will be introduced as well as measures for nuclear security. Once these elements are in place, it is necessary to establish institutions and organizations that will work together to develop nuclear security for each facility based on the regulations issued in the framework. Finally, once all of the necessary institutions are in place, nuclear security systems or physical protection systems can be designed and implemented at each facility. These nuclear security systems at these facilities, however, must be compatible with the administrative systems, institutions, and state entities that make up the legislative and regulatory frameworks. The system provides oversight, creating uniformity in the level and measures of security that are used to protect various facilities. We refer to this system and all of its parts, including the state bodies and institutions, facility operations, and physical protection systems, as a state's nuclear security regime. In addition to creating a robust legislative and regulatory framework, a state must also build a nuclear security culture. Nuclear security culture is the assembly of characteristics, attitudes, and behaviors of individuals, organizations, and institutions which serve as a means to support and enhance nuclear security. Although nuclear security culture is not mentioned as an essential element in Nuclear Security Series 20, it has its own implementing guide, which you can find. It's called Nuclear Security Series Number 7. Nuclear security culture deals with the people and personnel at these different points within the nuclear security regime, whether that is in the legislature, administrative areas, the state organizations responsible for nuclear security, or the personnel at the nuclear facilities. There is a particular focus with nuclear security culture on the personnel at nuclear facilities. The focus on personnel transcends from all levels at these facilities, from the high-level operators and managers to the lowest levels of staff. Nuclear security culture is a concept of organizational culture, creating norms within a facility. It creates avenues and expectations through which employees can carry out best practices in nuclear security. A strong nuclear security culture allows the employees to be cognizant of the different threats to the material within their facility. It provides training and creates expectations for employees at facilities. For example, these employees might have a culture to detect and report a colleague that they think might be trying to steal material or sabotage the facility. This would be considered an insider threat. It is also necessary to create avenues for these employees to report incidents, which is one of the ways that the upper management should have a strong security culture, by allowing these avenues for the lower employees to report these incidents and issues. Another example of security culture is with alarms and guards. All alarms could indicate an intruder. However, a strong security culture would ingrain norms for the guards to investigate every single alarm that goes off, even if the alarm is usually set off by a small animal or the wind, for example. The guards must know that it will be the one alarm not checked that will be the adversary if they don't check every alarm that goes off. For more information on nuclear security culture, refer to the NSSEP Nuclear Security Culture module.